Hello, this is Naren cyclic timer for single phase submersible pumps model CTCONT. This particular cyclic timer can be used for all the single phase submersible starters from 1 HP till 5 HP. This is a common starter. There is a contactor, two pole contactor built in, so you need not worry about the relays getting jammed. So this is a best solution and a common unit for all HP single phase submersible starters. So what is the cyclic timer? So basically the cyclic timer application is it will periodically turn on and off the motor. Okay, so let us take an example. So nowadays there is this dry run problem everywhere. Okay, so suppose there is a motor wherein as soon as you turn on the motor, there the motor can pump the water only for 25 to 30 minutes, after which the motor runs dry. So you will have a look at that and manually turn off the motor. So after that, after waiting for 1 hour or 2 hours, the motor, the water will get recharged again, and the motor can pump the water for the next 20 minutes or 30 minutes. So for all those kind of applications, you can set the on time and off time. Okay, I'll just give an example again. If I set the on time for 30 minutes, on time is the time for which the motor should run. Okay, so if I'm setting the on time for 30 minutes, the motor will start and run for 30 minutes, and the off time is always the waiting time. Okay, suppose if I want the motor to wait for 2 hours, after which again I want the motor to run for 30 minutes, I'll set this off time to be 2 hours. Okay, so if I'm setting the on time to be 30 minutes and the off time to be 2 hours, so what that means is the motor will start and it will continue to run for the first 30 minutes. After 30 minutes is over, the motor will enter the off cycle, wherein the motor will wait for 2 hours. Right, and after the 2 hours is completed, the motor will again switch back to the on cycle, wherein it will run for the next 30 minutes again, or the set on time. So this cycle keeps on repeating, and hence the name cyclic timer. Okay, so I hope the operation of cyclic timer is clear. Okay, then so we'll now go ahead and have a look at the connections of the cyclic timer. So as you can see, there is this 5-digit LED 7-segment display, wherein the rightmost 2 digits are the green color display, which are allocated to the on time setting, and the left 3 digits are the red color displays, which are allocated to the off time setting. Okay, and then you have this on and off switch and a press and release switch. I'll be explaining about the switch later. We'll now see the connections here. So you can see this red and yellow wires. This is the auxiliary supply. 220 volts phase and neutral has to be given to these two wires. Then you have two black wires, two green wires and two gray wires. Okay, these two black wires and green wires has to be connected in parallel to start or on push button, and these two gray wires has to be connected in series with the stop push button. Okay, I'll be explaining you how to make those connections. So before that, we'll go ahead and have a look at how a basic single phase starter looks like. So this is how it looks like. There will be this on push button or green push button and off push button. Okay, we'll now focus on the on push button or the green push button. I'll be opening the door. So if you can just see, yeah, this green push button will have two elements here. The button which I have used has one black element and one green element. This is called one element, one black element and one green element. Okay, there are two screws for every element. Okay, so now what I'll be doing is our cyclic timer had these two black wires and two green wires, correct? So what I'll be doing is I'll be drawing those two black wires and I'll be connecting it to the black element. These colors can be any other color also, so make sure you are connecting these two wires to one of the element, and the other two green wires have been connected to this element, the green color element, one here and one here. Okay, I hope the connections are clear. So it's okay even if these wires interchange. I mean to say, these black wires, if they come down, and these green wires if they come to the top portion, it's absolutely fine. The only thing is these two wires has to go to one particular element. Okay, I hope these connections are clear. So these two are parallel to start push button. So basically, again, one of the element will be the capacitor element and the other element will be the coil element. Okay, I hope these are clear. Then we'll go and have a look at the series connection to the stop push button. So these two gray wires has to be connected in series with the stop push button. So this is the stop push button, the red color one. So as we can see here, there'll be two screws to the stop push button. So there will just be one element for stop push button. So what we should do is this red wire is which is here was connected here. What I'm doing is I'm removing the red wire from this connector. Okay, I have connected one of the gray color wires to the one which was removed, the red color wire. I have connected and I have put a tape here. So this terminal is empty now. So what I'll be doing is I'll be taking the other gray color wire which was there and connecting it to the empty terminal.
Okay.
I'll repeat it again. This red color wire was given to the stop push button here. I have removed the red color wire from that place and I have connected one of the gray wires here and joined them. Okay. Then I have taken the other gray wire which was there and connected to this empty terminal from where I removed the red color wire. Okay. I hope this is called the series connection. So yeah, that's it. The connections are pretty simple. Once these connections are made, then we are good to go ahead and make the settings. We'll now check how to make the settings. Okay, so before that I'll be powering on the cyclic timer. All right, so to power on the cyclic timer you can use the switch. So whenever the cyclic timer operation is not required, you can always turn off the switch and you can continue to use your starter regularly like you were using all the other days. Okay, so I'll be turning on the cyclic timer. So you can see the rightmost green color displays, which are the on cycle, on display, and the leftmost three red color displays, which are the off time indication. Okay. So yeah, these are pretty much it. So let us now go ahead and see how to adjust the on cycle. Okay. Suppose I want my motor to run for 15 minutes and take a break of 30 minutes. Okay. We'll make the setting for that particular application. So in order to increase the off time, you will have to press this switch which is right below the on time. Okay, so I'll be pressing this switch. You can see this green color numbers increasing. It was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to set the on time to be 15 minutes, so I'll press this. So if I just go ahead, if I want to decrease the time, I'll have to immediately press the other button. So you can see the time decreasing. So since I want to set it to 15, I'll come till 15 and wait for a couple of seconds. You saw that blink. That blink indicates the on time has got saved. Okay. Suppose now we want to set the off time. So in order to set the off time, we'll have to press the button which is there right below the off time here. So I'll press this and you can see these three numbers increasing. I'm pressing this 1, 2, 3, the numbers are increasing. So suppose I want to set this off time to be 30 minutes. So I'll go ahead. I'll wait till it reaches 30. So if it crosses the value, if I want to decrease the number, I can immediately press the on time. So wherein this decreases. So I'll just wait for some couple of seconds. So you saw that blink. That blink indicates the timings got saved. I'll repeat the time settings again. In order to set the on time, first I'll be pressing this key which is right below the on time to see the numbers increasing. If I want to decrease the number, I'll be immediately pressing the other key so that the numbers will get decreased. And I'll wait until the timings get saved. Now the timings got saved, you saw that blink. Now if I want to set the off time, I'll press the key which is right below the off time. If I want to decrease it, I'll immediately press the other key. Okay. So I'll wait till the time you saw that blink, the timings got saved. So in order to see if the timings you've set has got saved or not, what you can do is you can always power off the display, power off the cyclic timer. So as soon as you power it on, for the first 5 seconds, the set timings will be displayed. Okay, I'll power it on. You can see 30 and 15, so 03015. That means 30 minutes of off time is set and 15 minutes of on time is set. So this display will be for the initial 5 seconds, and after which the timer will resume its operation. So I hope time settings are clear. Okay, so now comes the important point. So if you want to know which cycle the timer is in, you can always check this small dot blinking. So there is this dot blinking right next to 1. This indicates the timer is in off cycle right now. So wherever the dot is blinking, that the numbers there indicate the elapsed time. So the dot is blinking here, that means the timer is in off cycle. And what is this 001? 001 indicates the timer has been in off cycle from the past 1 minute. Okay. Similarly, after 2 minutes, this timings, this number will change to 2, 3, 4. So we have set the waiting time to be 30 minutes. It will keep on increasing till 30, after which it will switch over to the on time. If the cyclic timer is in on time, this blinking will be happening here, right next to the last, right next to 5 here in this case. Okay. So if the blinking is here, the time here indicates that the the elapsed time, similar to this one. So now the timings got changed to 2. That means the cyclic timer is in off time since 2 minutes. Similarly, if the blink is over here, the time indicates the elapsed time, the time since which the motor is running. So I hope this is clear. Now next, what about this press and release or the reset switch? The reset switch can always be used for the timer to switch over from the off cycle to on cycle. Suppose I for some reason immediately want to change the timings to on cycle. So I can always press the switch. This is like a bell push button. You can just press and release, wherein the timer will get reset. We'll go ahead and have a look at that. So in our indication, now we've set the on time to be 15 minutes and off time to be 30. This indicates the motor will run for the 15 minutes, then it will wait for 30 minutes, and then again it will run for 15 minutes, and this cycle will go on repeating. Okay, I'll now go ahead and press this press and release button. You can see this blinking, which will get shifted. It's been 3 minutes since the timer was in off condition. Now it will get shifted here. We'll press this. Okay, so you saw that blink. Okay. Yeah. So this means the motor is in on cycle now. Okay, you saw that blink here, right? So the motor switched over to the on time, and the blinking is here. So this cycle keeps on repeating. So now the motor will continue to be in on time for the next 15 minutes. You can see the motor running here on the analog meters and the indicators. So yeah, one more important thing is the model which I'm explaining now is the minute model. So this means the maximum on time that can be set is 99 minutes, and the maximum off time that can be set is 999 minutes. That is, the maximum on time is 1.5 hours here, and the maximum off time is 16 hours here. So if at all you want the timings to be more than this one, we can always suggest you with a different model. So you can always reach us on 99722-43774. That's my number. I'll repeat again. It's 99722-43774, and also you can visit us on our website. Our website is www.narenelectrics.in. I repeat, www.narenelectrics.in. Okay, so we can always get back to you if you have any specific requirements or any customization which is required. Okay, thanks for watching this video.